Today we are going to grow alum crystal, but the following steps are almost the same as growing copper 2 sulfate crystal. Crystallization is a process of formation of solid crystals precipitating from a solution. In this experiment, you will need alum, which can be found in the grocery store, in the section for spices or canning. Nylon thread and glass. To grow a larger crystal, you need to prepare seed crystals. Here it's how. Pour hot water into a clean jar. Add a little amount of alum and stir it well until all alum is dissolved. Add some more alum and stir it until it stops dissolving. We are going to just enough saturate the water. To do it faster, you can use a stirrer. By the way, don't add the whole amount into the jar, we are making seed crystal only. Saturated solution is made when you can see some alum at the bottom of the jar. Filter the solution in order to filter out dust, insoluble substances and excess alum. You can use filter paper and funnel. If you don't filter paper, you can use multifold towel paper. Cover the jar with a piece of paper to keep dust out. Allow the jar to sit undisturbed several hours or overnight. After a few hours, slowly pour alum solution from the first jar into a clean jar. You can see some alum crystals at the bottom of the jar. These are seed crystals that you will use to grow a big crystal. Choose the largest, best shaped crystal for your seed crystal. I think it is pretty good. Now tie the string around the seed chrysal and tie the other end to a pen, but a flat object is better. Yes, it is quite tricky to do so, but you really need to be patient. Okay, I have done. We will use it later. Now prepare another saturated alum solution, but this time, boil the water and add alum in the boiling water. Let it dissolve. When all alum is completely dissolved, add alum again until the solution changes to pale yellow or some alum cannot dissolve anymore. Once it's done, filter the solution using filter paper or multifold towel paper to filter out dust and undissolved alum. Put the seed crystal into the solution and place the pen over the jar so that the thread hangs down into the jar. If the string is too long when you place it in the solution, just roll the pen until the string becomes shorter. Make sure the crystal don't touch at the bottom of the jar. When you are done, you can place a piece of paper over the top of the jar to keep dust from getting into the crystals. Allow several days for crystals to grow. After a few days, you can take it out of the jar and put it on the filter paper or multifold towel paper. The crystal is pretty large, that's good. Finally, wash the crystal with minimum amount of cold water to remove dust and impurities on the surface. Dry the crystal using filter paper or multifold towel paper. There we have it, alum crystal, which is aluminum sulfate. It is used in water purification, which causes impurities to coagulate, which are removed as the particulate settles to the bottom of the container or more easily filtered. To make a larger crystal, you can use this as a seed crystal and heat the solution again to allow all alum is dissolved. Repeat the steps we did and you can have a super large crystal. Try this at home and thanks for watching.